Hi students, welcome back to Path Online Maths Tutorial. In previous lecture we have seen question number 1 and 2 of exercise 3.7 and in this lecture we are going to see further questions. Although question number 3 and 4 were given as homework, but we are doing it again so as to have a better understanding of these questions. Now in question number 3, it is asked the length, breadth and height of a room are 825 cm, 675 cm and 450 cm. We have to find the longest tape which can measure these three dimensions of the room exactly. Please mind this word exactly. Now what is given in this question? There is a room whose dimensions are given. Length is 825 cm, breadth is 675 cm and height is 450 cm. Now we have to find the length of the longest tape which can measure all these three dimensions exactly. Now how we can find the longest tape which can measure these three dimensions exactly? And what is the meaning of measuring these dimensions exactly? Now to know this, let's take a simple example. Suppose we have three ropes, rope 1, rope 2 and rope 3. So this is rope 1, this is rope 2 and this is rope 3. Let us assume their lengths also. Let us consider length of rope 1 as 9 meter, length of rope 2 as 12 meter and length of rope 3 as 15 meter. Let us now also assume a tape of length 4 meter. Let this be the tape of length 4 meter. So if we want to measure these lengths using this tape, how can we measure it? Let's try to measure the length of rope 2 using this tape. If we want to measure this length of rope 2 using this tape, we first keep one end of the rope to the initial point and then stretch it between the two points. So 4 meter tape, obviously 4 meter is not equal to 12 meter. Generally, हमारे पास tapes इतनी लंबी नहीं होती कि हम पूरी length को एक बार में measure कर सकें. So we take the measurement in parts. So when we stretch the rope first time, it will be from here to here. So this is first. So in one stretch, we can measure 4 meter and then we mark this point up to which we have measured. And then we stretched this tape between the next two points. This is again 4 meter. Now we have measured 4 plus 4, 8 meter of the length. In order to measure the remaining length, we again mark this point. And then we stretch the tape between these two points. So this again is 4 meter. Now 4 plus 4 plus 4 is equals to 12 meter. So using the tape of 4 meter, we have measured this 12 meter distance or 12 meter length of the rope with the tape of 4 meter in 3 attempts. Now if we try to measure the length of 9 meter using this same tape, we have to stretch it again like this. So it will be 4 meter in the first attempt and in the next attempt it will be 4 meter again. So 4 plus 4 is 8. So here this portion is left. So this portion which is left, we can measure this also. We can stretch this tape once again 4 meter and we can see the reading here, and this way we can measure the length of rope. But in this case, the number of measurements, the number of attempts were not exact because we are using a portion of measurement here. But in the second case, it was exact. In exact 3 attempts, we could measure 12 meter rope. So this is what we have to understand. The meaning of exactly is with the same length of the tape, we have to measure all three dimensions. I have taken simple examples here, 9 meter, 12 meter and 15 meter. But in this question, it is given 825 centimeter, 675 centimeter and 450 centimeter. So we have to check which tape can measure these lengths exactly. Not only that, the length of the tape should be longest. So two things you have to keep in mind. One is that what we are using tape in exact attempts mein, हम लेंथ को मेजर कर पाए, और दूसरा वो टेप लॉन्गेस्ट मेजर होना चाहिए उस टेप का. नाउ हाउ कैन वी फाइंड दैट? वी हैव डन दिस इन फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन आल्सो. व्हेनेवर लॉन्गेस्ट, हाईएस्ट, ग्रेटेस्ट वैल्यू इज आस्क्ड, वी ऑलवेज गो फॉर द HCF. If we find the HCF all these three numbers 9, 12 and 15, we will get the right answer. And we know how can we find the HCF in this case 9, 12 and 15, which number they are exactly divisible by. In case of HCF, we divide all three numbers together. So these three numbers are divisible by 3. So it becomes 3 3s are 9, 3 4s are 12 and 3 5s are 15. As we cannot divide these numbers any further by same number, so we stop our calculation here. This way we can find the HCF 3. That means using a tape of 3 meter, we can measure all these three lengths exactly. To measure 9 meter, how many times will we have to use this tape? 3 into 3. That means 3 times we have to measure, 3 times we have to use this tape to measure this length of 3 meter. To measure the length of 12 meter, we have to use this 3 meter tape 4 times. Suppose if we use 3 meter tape, we have to use it 4 times in order to measure this rope exactly. And for 15 meter, we have to measure or use this tape 5 times in order to measure the distance of 15 meter. I can show you also, first time in first stretch, we can measure 3 meter. In second stretch, you can measure next 3 meter, that means 3 plus 3 is 6. In next, we can measure more, 3 meter more, and it will become 9 meter. In next stretch, we can measure 3 meter more, that means 3 plus 3 plus 3 plus 3 equals to 12 meter. And in the last stretch, we can measure the entire length of the rope, which is 15 meter. So we have used exact length of the tape to measure this length. Now I hope the meaning of exactly is clear to you. Even then, if you find any difficulty in understanding this question, you can see this word here, longest. Whenever it is written in the question, longest, highest, greatest value, we need to find HCF. And whenever it is asked minimum, least, lowest values, we have to find LCM. So this is the case of LCM here. In this question, we were not given with ropes, but we were given with length, breadth and height of the room. So as the room is a cuboid shape, I have made the diagram of room for you. It is a cuboid. It is in the shape of room. So it has length, breadth and height. We need to measure all these three dimensions using the longest tape, which can measure them exactly. So by reading the statement, you should straight away know that we have to find HCF in this case. Many of the students who have sent their assignments, they have found LCM in place of HCF. So that's why I'm explaining in such detail, so that you may always understand when to find LCM and when to find HCF. Let's start this question now. In order to find longest tape, we have to find HCF of these three dimensions, HCF of 825 cm, 675 cm and 450 cm. And for uniformity, I told you one very simple method of finding HCF, that is prime factorization method. So what we do in that, we make a line diagram like this and we write all these quantities here, 825, 675 and 450 all together on this line diagram. Now we have to check which number can, which least prime number can divide all these three quantities. Because it is an odd number, it is not divisible by 2, so we cannot use 2. Now, next we have to check for 3. Now, 8 plus 2 is 10, 10 plus 5 is 15. 15 is divisible by 3, so we can divide this by 3. Now, let's check it also. 6 plus 7 is 13, 13 plus 5 is 18. 18 is also divisible by 3, so this number is also divisible by 3. 4 plus 5 plus 0 is 9. So 9 is also divisible by 3, so we can divide all these 3 numbers by 3. So the first number, the first prime number which we'll write here is 3. Now when we divide 825 by 3, what we'll get? Try to divide it right here. 3 2s are 6. 2 will be remainder and this 2 will come down. So we'll get 22. And 3 7s are 21. And when 21 is subtracted from 22, we'll get 1 as remainder. And this 5 will come down and we'll get 15. And 3 5s are 15. So you can check this also by dividing. If you divide 825 by 3, what will you get? Now 3 2s are 6 minus when 6 is subtracted from 2, we'll get 2 as remainder. This 2 will come down, so it will become 22. Now 3 7s are 21. When we subtract 21 from 22, we'll get 1 as remainder, and this 5 will come down, so we'll get 15 here. Now 3 5s are 15. So when we subtract it, we get 0. So that means 825 is exactly divisible by 3, and on dividing we will get 275. So you can try to do this calculation in your mind itself. Now let's try this. When we divide 675 by 3, now 3 2s are 6, which is exactly divisible. This 7 will come down. Once again we'll use 2. 3 2s are 6. When 6 is subtracted from 7, 1 will be remainder, and 1 and 5 will become 15. So 3 5s are 15. We'll get 225 when we divide 675 by 3. So you can check it yourself. Now 450. Now when we divide 450 by 3, 3 1s are 3. When 3 is subtracted from this 4, we'll get 1 as remainder, and then it will become 15. 3 5s are 15, and this 0 will write as it is. So this way we can divide very fast if we try to do the calculation in our mind. But if you find any difficulty, you should go for the calculations. Don't take chances if you have any doubt. Now once again we have to check which number can divide all these three numbers exactly. Now because these are odd number, they are not divisible by 2. So we'll check for 3. 7 plus 2 is 9. 9 plus 5 is 14. That means 275 is not divisible by 3. So we cannot use 3 here, because all the numbers should be divisible by 3 while we find HCF, because we are finding here HCF. So which number can we use? The unit place of all the numbers is either 0 or 5. So all these numbers are divisible by 5. So I can use 5 here. Now 5 5s are 25. 2 will be remainder, and this 5 will make 25. Once again I can write 5. 5 5s are 25. You can check this by dividing also. Now once again, when we divide 225 by 5, 5 4s are 20. When we subtract 20 from 22, 2 will be remainder, and this 5 will make 25 with that 2. So 5 5s are 25, so we'll get 45 here. Now when we divide 150 by 5, we know 5 3s are 15, and this 0 will write as it is. Now once again, all these three numbers are divisible by 5, because the unit place of all the numbers is either 0 or 5 here. So when I divide these numbers by 5 again, 5 11s are 55, 5 9s are 45, and 5 6s are 30. Now can we divide all these three numbers by same prime number? 11 is not divisible by 3. 9 and 6 are divisible by 3, but this 11 is not divisible by 3, nor these numbers are divisible by 5 or any other number. So we can stop our calculation right here. So this you have to keep in mind. When we find LCM, we keep on dividing all the numbers by the same prime number, and we stop the calculation when we cannot divide all these numbers by the same prime number, and we find the product of these numbers. That will be the HCF. HCF of 825, 675, and 450 will be equal to product of 3, 5, and 5. So it will be equal to 3 into 5 into 5. Now we know 5 into 5 is 25, and 25 into 3 is 75. So in this case 75 is the LCM. That means we can use a tape of 75 cm which can measure all these three dimensions, length, breadth, and height of the room, in exact number of times. Therefore, length of longest tape required is 75 centimeter. Thus, the answer in this case is length of the longest tape required is 75 centimeter. So I hope you find this question easy, and you always try to look for longest, greatest or highest values. Such values will help you find HCF and LCM in any question. Let's now see question number 4 also.